Okay, I think her horse did better than mine. I had her stop on the outside range, and he would just stop and pivot over the inside shoulder. There we go. All in the setup.
She rode all while we were growing up and had horses and did the equestrian team in college. And when she lived there, she lived nowhere in Florida. Somewhere in Florida for a while. There's always someone to ride in Florida. Mm-hmm. And when she moved to Savannah, she didn't realize what she was doing. There was really no size wise.
Yeah. There's like one and a half, and then there's six.
She ended up riding a place called Echelon, sport horses. But I think it was like 45 minutes outside the city.
Yeah, it's always just kind of like in the city, like seriously ones like behind all of the shore.
Mm-hmm.
Right there, sort of driving somewhere. Very strange, but you know,
just kind of looking for
it really is.
Full of like 50-year-old women horses who can control.
Oh. I'm sure, not that I know what, when I get there.
pays $1,000 per horse.
Yeah, for two horses.
To be cared for.
Yeah.
So she's the blood bowl.
And it's like, she sounds like, if she gave me like 50 bucks a week, I would actually rush them and stuff. And I was like, oh, she's too bad. I'm just going to get out. Maybe you pay like so much money for nothing. For these two horses, just like sitting here.
Like she's not prepared, so you have to like, do customer service basically.
She's not using her and she's not using any of my but she won't.
She would never let you do it, right?
Yeah.
God, I could I can think of so many barn owners who would have to have quarters and have to
that's like crazy. That's like he said, oh, this is best quarter.
Yeah, one of your horses.